And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to Let's Play System... Not System Shock 2. I would rather much play System Shock 2 right now. Now, we are playing Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. And we have found out another thing last time. Namely, that this game is bullshit. It's fucking bullshit, in fact. To be more precise. Because it appears that Mr. Hyde... Well, sorry, Dr. Jekyll... is actually... So, the problem is that Dr. Jekyll doesn't jump as far when you jump to the right as compared when you jump to the left. Which seems odd, but I can pretty much guarantee you that this is a fact. Because I've checked this now several times. And yeah. So whenever the purple guy lays his bombs, what he do is, if you are sensible, you jump to the left, not to the right. Which is tempting because, well, you want to make progress and you don't want to spend your whole fucking life playing this fucking game. But if you jump to the left, you will live longer and eventually beat this game, so. Also, fuck this game. So now we have basically two strategies that we are working with. First of all, we try to enjoy the basic gameplay that we have to deal with, even though it's hard. And the second rule is that we always, always jump to the left. No matter how tempting it is. Even if there are no barrels rolling towards you, it's still a better idea just to jump to the left. There's not much that you can do about the speed-ups, though. Okay, now the barrels have stopped. And I can make... Well, I can't. Make this passage. Nope. This is so frustrating. And we're getting closer and closer to the point of not being able to go back to the Hyde form, basically. Because we're going to die before we have the opportunity to make any significant progress as Hyde, so. And we can, of course, get killed by the stairs whenever the game feels like it. But we've made it this time, at least. Okay. Okay, this was very good. There are no barrels in sight. Well, there are some barrels now. Okay, force him to lay his bombs, then run away to the left, rinse and repeat. Okay. Still have to remember not get hit by the bomb. But sometimes you can't avoid the bomb blast, it seems. Shit, I was... So I... For a moment, my finger slipped off the controls, and then... Yeah, I lost precious seconds there. Ah, fuck you! I hate these fucking red orbs. I hate these orbs. Fuck you. The deadly psycho wave. Fucking piece of shit game. Fuck you. This game is just... it's just a mess, let's be honest. And I'm going to die here. Even though I'm... no, I'm not. Fuck you, game. Not this time. Not this time. Okay, remember what our strategy is. Okay, sometimes. Okay, so you should jump early because whether you are affected by the bomb blast also depends on the height. Where that you have. So we've made it as far as we've never made it. But that means nothing, of course, because we can die at any moment. And we can die, of course. We can get killed by these stairs at any moment. Just wait for it. We're going to get killed by these stairs. All these barrels. Whatever comes first. Or this purple guy, which... Laces. Okay, now we have some speed ups. Let us be careful here, because we've never made it this far. And if we can just... make it past all these barrels, then maybe we have a chance of actually beating this game. As unlikely as that sounds, though. Okay, now we need to survive this height stage. And we're not off to a good start at all. We're not off to a good start at all. I have trouble killing this guy. Well, I could have use of a little bit of enemies, please. Preferably those jumping brains, because they are easy to defeat. Not these red orbs. And we are dead. Hooray. And by hooray, I mean not hooray. Well, at least we've sort of, well, verified our strategy in so far as using the strategy of always jumping to the left and of trying to enjoy the basic gameplay. Taking our time, that we've made it as far as we've never made it in this game. Well, in this level, I mean, well, which is also as far as we've ever made it in this game, of course. So yeah, the strategy seems to work out. That's all I can say here. The controls are still wonky as shit. But at least our strategy seems to be the correct one. Okay, I'm clearly getting better at avoiding this dog, at least. If nothing else, then I'm getting better at that. And this was stupid. This was stupid. This was very stupid. Yes, it was. So, I really hope that this game is not out of sync because of all these speed up glitches. The recording, what did I say? I wanted to say recording. That recording is not out of sync. Haha, I dodged that barely. Yeah, so at least the barrels sometimes work in your favor. When you're trying to walk away from a bomb. The speed up never really works in your favor. Never really does. Okay. Aha, I made it. Then I get hit by this note, of course. And I walk right into a projectile. Hooray. This was stupid. Yes, it was. So I should try to... I should learn how to... There are too many enemies on screen. I should really try to come up with some strategy to defeat these red orbs, or at least to avoid their projectiles. I mean, it does seem to me that they, well, at least the number of projectiles is randomized, but it also seems that the directions which the projectiles take is randomized too, but this could be actually... could be mistaken there, actually, so... If they are not random, then... Clearly I just need to... Well, what I need to do is learn... I need to remember the basic strategy. Always jump to the left. So when we'll come back, folks, yeah, we'll continue to try beat the last level of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. I mean, we've made quite a lot of progress today, and perhaps we can finish the game next time or the time after that, but that, yeah, shall wait until next time. So, as always, until next time, folks, until then.